Γεια σας! Welcome to a new lesson. In Greek we can write the sound E with six different ways. Three vowels, ita, iota and ypsilon, and three diphthongs, epsilon iota, omicron iota and ypsilon iota. As their pronunciation is exactly same, it is really hard for the Greek language learners to decide which one they should use to write correctly the sound E. Of course, in ancient Greek their pronunciation was different. For example, ita was always a long E, while omicron iota was normally a long E too, but when it was written at the end of a noun or an adjective, it was pronounced like short E. Anyway, today we pronounce all of them with the same way. So you have to memorize the correct spelling of many words. This is something you cannot avoid in Greek. But also there are some grammatical rules and I will try to concentrate them for you. Let's start from the definite article. The feminine definite article in singular, it is written with ita in all cases. Let's see. Nominative, I. Genitive, tis. Accusative, ti or tin. If you don't know when the feminine definite article in accusative singular it is written and pronounced like ti and when like tin, you can watch the video you will find below. Look at the genitive singular, tis. It is written with ita. Another definite article sounds exactly the same is tis, which is written with iota. Again, it is a feminine definite article in accusative plural. It is a common mistake that almost all the beginners make. So, when you hear the sound tis, you should be sure that it is a feminine definite article. If it is written with ita, it is singular, genitive singular. If it is written with iota, it is plural, accusative plural. The feminine and masculine definite article in nominative plural is same, and it is written with omicron iota. I, gates. A feminine noun which means the cats. I, tragoudistes. A masculine noun which means the singer, so omicron iota is for plural. You should learn very good the definite article. It is very, very useful, and sometimes it helps us to write correctly the noun endings too. For example, we've learned that the feminine definite article in singular, it is written with ita. So, the feminine nouns ending in I are written with ita too. Let's see. Ilimni, the lake. Nominative, I, ilimni. Genitive, tis, limnis. Accusative, ti, limni. The noun endings are exactly same with the endings of the definite article, right? Let's see the fourth and last for today rule. The masculine nouns and adjectives, which in nominative singular end in os, for example, ο άνθρωπος, the human being, ο ψηλός, tall, in nominative and vocative plural and in I, and this I is written with omicron iota. Do you remember we said that omicron iota is for plural? Let's see. Nominative plural, I άνθρωποι. Vocative plural, άνθρωποι. Let's see the adjective. Nominative plural, I ψηλοί. Vocative plural, ψηλή. If you need further information about the masculine nouns and the definite articles, you can watch the videos you will find in the description box. Don't forget that you can find all the notes in my blog, and you can write your questions in the comments or you can text me on Instagram. Thank you for watching this video. If you found it useful, please give a thumbs up, share, subscribe to my channel, and don't forget to press on the notification bell so get notified whenever I upload any new videos. See you soon. Adios!